Video? Yeah, you're 1 second in now.
Okay. Well, good morning. A little bit of music while we gather. Click the right button. Have we got the right screen there? Yeah. That's a bit low.
Yes, that's the correct screen, I think.
Oh, that's the wrong track. Sorry. Oh, what's happening? Sorry, I could hear something.
Yes, because my volume was up on it. I didn't turn it down yet.
I didn't know what I could hear. I thought something had gone wrong with me. Right. Just give me a second. Oh gosh, about to get the next track. Oh, it's a nurse. We don't want the non-dimitis.
Jeffrey Weaver.
Right. What have we got on the screen?
Thank you.
So, good morning, and a very warm welcome to you all. Am I close enough? Hold on. Excuse me a moment. I don't understand why my phone is making a noise when it's on silent. There you go, it's got rid of that. Yes, good to see we've got 15 of us.
Nope, 16 now.
16 now, right. Well, as usual, while some people are still gathering, we'll have the notices now and then we'll repeat them at the end of the service. What have we got? No birthdays or anniversaries that I'm aware of, so put them in the comments if you've got an anniversary or a birthday.
There's one here. Helen Slaney, good morning. Our granddaughter Emily is 21 on Tuesday. Please wish her... Please wishes her happy birthday and pray for her. Thank you.
Right, thank you. Can you write that down on your pad and then I'll stand a chance of doing
yes,
it.
Okay.
Okay, so happy birthday to Helen Slaney's grandchild.
Granddaughter, Emily.
Happy birthday to Emily. So that's good. So do let me know if there are any anniversaries as well, and I will include you with at the intercessions. We pray for the youth group later on as they go and do their activities. And there wasn't an all-age service this week because, to be perfectly honest with you, I didn't have time. They take a lot of recording and I was faffing with today's sermon for this service instead. And when you see the sermon and all the illustrations, you'll see why that took longer than it should have done as well for the, on the technology side of things. So, Thursday Bible study, zooming away. Unfortunately, all sorts of things prevented most people from coming last Thursday. So we abandoned ship and we will resume this coming Thursday with session two. So that will be good. Please do come along if you can. I'll send the invitation to anyone who's already shown a bit of interest. Just ignore it if you don't want to come. If you're one of those that have come and you want to send apologies, always accepted. And if you want an invitation, then let me have your email address. And I think that's it for notices. So let's start our worship. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
We have a very special guest with us, our new curate, Gary, and his wife Carol. They have produced a little video to introduce themselves, and unfortunately Gary, although it played perfectly well on my computer on the PowerPoint, you come in after a little bit. You eventually appear, at least you did when I tried it out earlier. So here they are.
Well, good morning. I just thought I'd spend a few moments just introducing myself. So I'm Gary.
And I'm Carol.
And we also have two other little Higgses, which are Alexandra and Lily.
Have they appeared yet?
So we finally moved in to Denston, into the house, on Saturday the 13th of June, after a slight delay due to the coronavirus pandemic. But we're really, really pleased to be here. We'd like to thank you all for your cards and the flowers. They've really made us feel welcome, even if we don't get to meet all of you face to face. We've met some of the neighbours around the street, which has been really nice, and the children have met some of the other children.
And we also want to say a big thank you to Never Made Cake for us. It's been absolutely delicious. It's really helped with the unpacking.
Yeah, so I'm looking forward to meeting you all in person or via Zoom or however we're going to do it in the coming weeks and months. I'd like to thank you all for your prayers on our journey up to Denston. I know that Liz has been mentioning us in the Sunday services she's been doing via Facebook Live, and that really means a lot to us, knowing that we've been held in prayer for a number of weeks now as we've been preparing to move and relocate here with you guys. So thank you very much.
Thank you. Let's give them a warm welcome. Two thumbs up and hearts and whatever. So welcome to the Higgses. And Gary will be appearing in the service later. He will do the readings and the prayers of intercession. Technology willing. Yeah. But for now, let's have our first opening hymn, which is Fight the Good Fight.
Fight
Let us come before God, opening up our hearts and our minds to his presence with us today. Loving God, we thank you for this opportunity to worship together, albeit in separate places. Help us to worship you in spirit and in truth, that we may live lives worthy of being called Christians. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
And the Bible assures us that God loved the world so much that he gave his son Jesus to save us from our sins, to forgive us, to speak up for us in heaven and bring us to eternal life. So let's call to mind our sins, and if there's anything in particular, you can hold that up to God as we say the responsive prayer together. Most merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, we confess that we have sinned in thought, word and deed. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbours as ourselves. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
In your mercy, forgive what we have been. Help us to amend what we are and direct what we shall be, that we may do justly, love mercy, and walk humbly with you, our God. Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. So knowing that we are forgiven, let us join together. Oh, please say amen for the special prayer set for today. And I think it's the third Sunday of Trinity. There we go. Nearly read the wrong collect. Almighty God, you have broken the tyranny of sin and have sent the Spirit of your Son into our hearts, whereby we call you Father. Give us grace to dedicate our freedom to your service, that we and all creation may be brought to the glorious liberty of the children of God, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
So hopefully Gary will now read first the New Testament reading and then he moves straight into the Gospel. If you know the responses, do join in, but they're not printed on the screen.
The New Testament reading is from Romans chapter 6, verses 12 to 23. Therefore, do not let sin exercise dominion in your mortal bodies to make you obey their passions. No longer present your members to sin as instruments of wickedness, but present yourselves to God as those who have been brought from death to life, and present your members to God as instruments of righteousness. For sin will have no dominion over you, since you are not under law, but under grace. What then? Should we sin because we are not under the law, but under grace? By no means. Do you not know that if you present yourselves to anyone as obedient slaves, you are slaves of the one whom you obey, either sin, which leads to death, or of obedience, which leads to righteousness? But thanks be to God that you, having once been slaves of sin, have become obedient from the heart to the form of teaching to which you were entrusted, and that you, having been set free from sin, have become slaves of righteousness. I'm speaking in human terms because of your mortal limitations. For just as you once presented your members as slaves to impurity and to greater and greater iniquity, so now present your members as slaves to righteousness for sanctification. When you were slaves of sin, you were free in regards to righteousness. So what advantage did you then get from the things of which you were now ashamed? The end of those things is death. But now that you have been freed from sin and enslaved to God, the advantage you get is sanctification. The end is eternal life, for the wages of sin is death, but the free gift of God is eternal life in Jesus Christ our Lord. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. I'm wondering if it's loud enough, it's turning up a little bit.
Hear the gospel of our Lord according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Whomever welcomes you welcomes me, and whoever welcomes me welcomes the one who sent me. Whoever welcomes a prophet into the name of a prophet will receive a prophet's reward. And whoever welcomes a righteous person in the name of a righteous person will receive the reward of the righteous. And whoever gives even a cup of cold water to one of these little ones in the name of a disciple, truly I tell you, none of these will lose their reward. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ. So may the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, Lord God, our strength and our Redeemer. Zoom in a bit, but there's pictures on the screen. They'll need to see the screen.
Well, I can't zoom in like this because your head disappears off the top anyway.
Oh, we don't want my head disappearing. So is that, can you see me and it and, yeah. So, just before I start, while I remember, what a wonderful coincidence that I chose Peace, Perfect Peace for our music as we gathered. And just as I checked on my phone, I hadn't looked at it and didn't know, but that's what Susan was talking about in her reflection that went out earlier. My peace I give to you. Isn't that wonderful to know that God is at work in these so-called coincidences? So anyway, let's pray. Father God, we thank you that you are with us and in us and that you guide us in all of our thinking and in all of our doing. Guide us now as I preach to each of us take away from this what you want us to hear. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
So, whoever gives a cup of cold water to one of these little ones in the name of a disciple will never lose his reward. Well, our gospel today is at the end of that section that we had some of last week. Jesus had sent the apostles out to spread the good news of healing, casting out demons, and he warned them that not everyone would welcome them, but wherever they were offered hospitality, it was almost as if the people would be welcoming Jesus, because when we go out in Jesus' name, we are representing him. It's almost as if he were there himself. And so therefore, whenever we welcome the stranger and offer hospitality to someone, we won't know necessarily if they're a Christian or not. But if they are a Christian, then however we treat them is how we treat Jesus. We may be shunning Christ inadvertently. Remember the parable that Jesus gave, told about the sheep and the goats? When I needed a neighbour, were you there? Drink, food, clothing, sick, in prison. And when did I do or not do that? Well, whatever we do to the least of Jesus' brothers and sisters, in other words, other Christians, we do or do not do for him. Elsewhere, of course, it is made clear that we should love everybody, regardless of their faith. But who are these little ones? I've just noticed that the picture I've got to go with this is from Mark, not Matthew. And Mark doesn't say the little ones. I didn't notice that till this morning. But who are the little ones? Well, they're the opposite to the big ones. I think not the leaders, not the experience. You know, the little ones are not the experienced. They're the ones not big in the faith. Perhaps in our context, people who say, yeah, I follow Jesus, or yeah, I want to join in, I want to identify as a Christian, but I may not go to church and I may not do very much. I don't know. But our online worship has been showing hospitality to many people who aren't normally in church on a Sunday, and that's brilliant. The worship isn't the best. Perhaps like a cup of water, refreshing on a hot day, but not necessarily the best or what you choose to drink normally. But it's the best we can do. But lockdown is ending. Yay! We're back to church from next Sunday. At least we can be. If you're still not isolating, everyone is welcome if they're able to come. And if online worship is like a cup of water, then worshipping together in the same building is like champagne or beverage, beautiful beverage of your choice if you don't drink alcohol. A cup of hot chocolate, perhaps, with all the froth and the marshmallows on the top. It's bringing together for worship is so much better than the online. But there won't be refreshments and there won't be hugging. We'll have the rules to follow when the Church of England have had news from the government. That's what the delay is. The government haven't said. But anyway, lockdown is ending. And it's shown many people what's important in life. Relationships, family, meaningful work. People have had time to think, perhaps too much time with your own inner thoughts. New habits of prayer and worship have developed with our online worship. And we need to think, well, what are we going back to? We're actually going back to the future. We're not going back to the way it was. We've got the opportunity to go back to something better. Freedom beckons, but what will we do? I believe society in general will go back to being selfish. We've already seen that with those photos of the beaches, and we experience, well, those of you that go shopping, Terry tells me how people are shoving past each other in Aldi and places like that. But what about you and me? What about those of us who say we follow Christ? How will we use our freedom? And that's what the first reading was addressing. Paul's writing to the church in Rome, and he uses the analogy of slavery. Now, we find it hard to understand the concepts of slavery as used by Paul in the New Testament. We tend to think of the black slave trade, South America and the plantations, or modern day slavery, perhaps, sex trade, car washes, fruit pickers. It was different in Paul's day, and we have to remember that. And those who were Jews would have thought of being a slave or a servant of God. If they're thinking of Moses and David and Elijah, they would have thought of honour and privilege, not enforced hard labour. So being enslaved to someone means being bound to them, belonging to them. And in a way, it's a bit like Mr. and Mrs. We are bound to each other. We obey each other. And when we turn to God through Jesus, asking him to forgive us and put right our relationship with God, then the old self has gone. It's like it's on the cross. Our sin is all paid for and done and forgiven. And we become a new person. And I just noticed this morning that you've still got on your picture there the I, the capital I in sin, just on, I don't know if you can see it, just in the corner. I didn't clip off my pencil scribbles. The old has gone, the new has come. And my favourite hymn is, "And Can It Be?" My chains fell off. My heart was free. I rose, went forth and followed thee. Slavery to sin ends. No longer bound to selfishness. Chains, obviously, a symbol of slavery. They've been cut. Our heart is free. It's no longer, we're no longer tied in our emotions or in our instincts to do what is wrong. That's been cut off. It's like a balloon been let go of. We are born into eternal life, and it's through the grace of God, Jesus on the cross. He paid for us, and it's like the wine of Holy Communion is the blood of the covenant. The promises made between God and us were sealed by his blood on the cross. Not like a marriage is sealed with the kiss and the words of the priest and what God has put together, let no one put asunder, you're bound together. Well, the covenant between us and God is sealed with Jesus' blood on the cross, which is what we remember in the wine of Holy Communion. And if the heart is represented by a balloon, who's got hold of the string? Who's got hold of your string? Who's got the strings of your heart? We are under grace. A cloud, a golden cloud of grace, not the cloud of dark cloud of depression or the authority of the law, but we're under grace, the gift of God. We are new creations. There's a song, I am a new creation, no more in condemnation. Here in the grace of God I stand. And I wish I could find it on YouTube. But years ago, a theatre group did a parody of that. It starts off with a young person full of the joys of being a new Christian. I'm a new creation, blah, blah, blah. And with each repeat, the person singing gets less and less joyful and they're dragged down with loads of bad stuff. Why does that happen? Why does all the joy and enthusiasm evaporate with new Christians when the difficulties of following Jesus arise? Well, I think part of it is, yes, we're free from rules and regulations to be right with God, but the danger is that we do what we feel is right. We follow our instincts. And what drives your instincts? What drives your feeling of what is right or wrong? Yes. It's up here. It's in your mind as well as in your guts. Who's in charge of your mind? Is it you? Is it me? Me? Or is it Christ? Do we have the mind of Christ? Do we know what he would want us to do? Is he in the driving seat of our lives? Well, we need to choose what we do with this newfound freedom. We need to choose to live under grace. I don't think I remember to pull that across. There you go. What road are we going to take? Are we going to take the one that leads to eternal life or eternal death? Let's just have a look at those. The road to death, spiritual death, separation from God, is lined with all sorts of things that Paul wrote about to the Galatian church. Dissensions, drunkenness, impurity, witchcraft, idolatry, hatred. In other words, selfishness, me, the I in sin. But what about the road that leads to fullness of life, eternal life? It starts now as soon as we trust in Jesus. Fullness of life is hope and healing, friendship with God, acceptance, love, joy, peace, patience. All the fruits of the Spirit start growing. That is the road to eternal life. And the peace of Christ is ruling in our hearts. It's him in charge, not me. But we all have the choice. Do you want to do right or do you want to do wrong? Do you want to love or do you want to hate? Do you want to help or do you want to hinder good community, justice, loving, have eternal life or eternal separation? Jesus makes it clear, if you go down the road of selfishness, the wages of that or the result of that is death, spiritual death. But the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Jesus invites us to enter this new way of life, the way of the cross, the way of grace, accepting his invitation. And the daily challenges that we face is to live this life of the new self. The Christian is bound to Christ, empowered by the Holy Spirit. And it's, how do we not fall back into the old selfish, sinful habits and behaviour, the ways of thinking? And it takes a long time to break the old habits and to form new ones. I wonder if this 3 months of lockdown and getting back to prayer for some people has been long enough to form new habits. I hope it has. Daily, we need to die to self. Those who belong to Christ Jesus have crucified the sinful nature with its passions and desires. You've put yourself on the cross. You've said, not me, but you, Lord. And if the heart is a balloon on a string, well, who's holding that string? Is it the Holy Spirit? Is it the Spirit of Christ? Is it Jesus? Since we live by the Spirit, let us keep in step with the Spirit. Paul wrote that to the Galatians. So the Spirit of God, the Holy Spirit, will help us keep on the right road. All we need to do is to allow the Holy Spirit more and more into our lives. and then we will be able to walk the way of the cross, the way of Jesus, the way of grace, the way of fullness of life. I want to finish with a prayer that came from the Holy Island. It's a lovely prayer based on the idea of being bound to God. Let us pray. I bind my mind to the mind of the Creator God, and I loose from my mind all that offends my God, that I may worship completely. I bind my body to the will of the Saviour Christ, and I loose from my body all disease, that I may serve freely. I bind my spirit to the Holy Spirit, my helper, and I loose from my spirit all that is not of my God, that I may love joyfully. Amen. So we come now to the Creed, our affirmation of faith. Let us declare our faith in God. We believe in God the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named. We believe in God the Son, who lives in our hearts through faith and fills us with his love. We believe in God the Holy Spirit, who strengthens us with power from on high. We believe in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. So we come now to our intercessions. Before I put Gary on with his, I've got a thank you to God for answered prayer. And Terry can pass me his pad for pray for anyone, any anniversaries come up.
There is what was said earlier on, Helen Slaney's granddaughter Emily.
Yeah.
I can't remember what the birthday that was now.
Okay.
Oh, just a second.
But no anniversaries.
21 on Tuesday. And on the 3rd, I've got here, on the 3rd...
I don't know if you can hear, Terry.
Okay.
And on the 3rd...
The 3rd, on Friday, it's Neil Hutchinson's birthday.
Neil Hutchinson on the 3rd, and what the... That's why I need things written down, because my brain doesn't retain things. Emily, they say the short-term memory goes first.
Emily on Tuesday.
So 21. We pray for Emily, 21, on Tuesday, and Neil at an undisclosed age on Friday. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the blessings of anniversaries and birthdays, and we pray for Emily and Neil that they will enjoy more of your love in their lives. In Jesus' name, amen. And we've got some good news, some answer to prayer for healing. We had a healing service a few months ago when we were allowed in church, and there was a chap called Tom who came along, and he'd got skin cancer over his right eye. He and his wife felt really blessed during the service, and I remember we prayed for them with the laying on of hands and anointing with oil. And he's been on a new experimental treatment since then, which aims to reduce the cancer, but doesn't expect to eliminate it. I'll wait for the clock to finish.
The 11th hour.
Yeah. I'm sure that was more than 11. Right, so Tom has been on the experimental treatment, and it aims to reduce the cancer but not eliminate it, and that's an important piece of information. He had another biopsy a couple of weeks ago, well, probably three now, and they found no trace of the cancer anywhere. The doctors are amazed, way beyond their expectations. He'll need plastic surgery to repair his appearance, but the cancer has gone. Praise God. So healing, prayers for healing are answered. Praise God. So, Father God, we thank you for Tom, and we thank you for your healing grace at work in our healing services. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, so.
May there be many more.
And may there be many more, yes, when we're allowed. And so, over to
Gary,
thank you. To Gary. He'll soon get used to me not knowing names.
We come now to a time of intercession. The response, well, I'll say, Lord, hear us. And the response will be, Lord, graciously hear us. Dear Lord, we come to you with thanks today. Thanks for a new day, a fresh day that we have with you. We thank you for the courage that you give people, especially thinking of people within the NHS circle, those frontline doctors and nurses that are dealing with sick people day in, day out, down to drivers restocking medical supplies. People that are cleaning wards, restocking shelves. The carers, the ones that look after our sick families, the on-call doctors and nurses. We pray for them all today. We thank you that their hard work and their commitment is their calling. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for the sick. We pray for Judith, Eileen Warren, Paula, Riley Massey, Sue Easter, Winnie Parsons, Michelle Doxey, Harrison, Pat Oakes, Lucy Chapman, Graham Oakes, Ken Langton, and Sam Gilbert. We pray that your healing hand touch them, and that you know that you're always with them, wherever they are, whatever they're going through. Short period of silence to add any names you want to that list, out loud or in your hearts. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. We think about the people that have died before us, whether that be today or in the past. We remember those with fond memories. We think about the empty spaces around the tables during Sunday dinner, and the places that we used to go with them. Remember the good moments in the lives that brought us all together. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Especially think of Grace Poppy Burton today, who died a year ago. We think especially of her parents, Gary and Sally Ann, and of her twin sister, Charlotte. Only a short time in this world, Lord, but that time spent was precious. Time that will never be forgotten and can never be forgotten. We ask that you look after Poppy until the time where people are reunited. We give you thanks for the short life that she had. Especially remember them as this is the time of an anniversary for them. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We think about the struggles of the world as well today, Lord. We think about all of the people on furlough. We think of all the companies that are now looking at redundancies, now looking at how they're going to restart their businesses during this pandemic, because this pandemic isn't over. It's still very much with us.
Yes.
I think in particular of JCB. I think of company that I worked for many years. 90 redundancies that were announced there last week in all areas of the factory. I think of the 2,000 people that have been put at risk at Royal Mail. Just be with them. Be with those people as they find this difficult time in their life. Whether they know you or not, just touch them. Know that your healing hand and listening ear is there. Be with the people in these companies that make those decisions, that put the lists together, that try to find ways of not making people redundant. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
And we pray for the world in general, the groans that it's sustaining, the things that are going on, the coronavirus, the terrorism, the poverty, the homelessness. We think of all those things today, knowing that you know them all and that they are all sat with you. As perhaps we sit from our houses, our flats, our places of refuge, and you think about the ones that are worse off than us and how we are able to help those people. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
And a prayer that I've been saying for the last few days, Lord, is about my fellow colleagues in training, that 27th of June should be ordination, but due to the pandemic has been postponed. So those of us that have been licensed or waiting licensing, we pray that your protection is over them, as I know the anxieties run high, but it will come and you will welcome each and every one of us into your loving arms of the church for ordination at some point. I pray for those people that are moving house, finishing work. Be with them and their families. May the open arms of your loving church welcome them into a different stage of their lives. Lord, hear us.
Lord graciously hear us.
A merciful Father,
accept these prayers
for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you, Gary. Let us pray for Gary, because obviously he's not going to be praying for himself. Father God, we pray for Gary as he settles into this benefice. Bless him with your presence and your grace as we together work out what we're going to do with him in these strange circumstances. Lord, guide us as we seek to determine the training that he receives here. Help his family to settle even more into the community. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Yes. So we come now to the peace. Christ is our peace. He has reconciled us to God in one body by the cross. We meet in his name and share his peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us offer one another a sign of peace. And as you do that, I will put the music on for our next hymn, which I've forgotten what it is. I think it's And Can It Be? Yeah, that's it. Anything happening? Peace be with you, my darling. Don't say peace to everyone in there.
That's
enjoyed that, Terry. If you are following the prayers, if you've got the Book of Common, not the Book of Common Prayer, the other one, Common Worship, it is Prayer E that we are using. Prayer E. The Lord is here.
His Spirit is with us.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give thanks and praise. Father, you made the world and love your creation. You gave your Son, Jesus Christ, to be our Saviour. His dying and rising have set us free from sin and death. And so we gladly thank you with saints and angels, praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. We praise and bless you, loving Father, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And as we obey his command, send your Holy Spirit that broken bread and wine outpoured may be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. On the night before he died, he had supper with his friends, and taking bread, he praised you. He broke the bread, gave it to them, and said, Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. When supper was ended, he took the cup of wine. Again he praised you, gave it to them, and said, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. So, Father, we remember all that Jesus did. In him we plead with confidence, his sacrifice made once for all upon the cross. Bringing before you the bread of life and cup of salvation, we proclaim his death and resurrection until he comes in glory. Jesus Christ has died.
Jesus Christ has died.
Jesus Christ has risen.
Jesus Christ has risen.
Jesus Christ will come again.
Jesus Christ will come again.
Lord of all life, help us to work together for that day when your kingdom comes and justice and mercy will be seen in all the earth. Look with favour on your people, gather us in your loving arms and bring us with all the saints to feast at your table in heaven, through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit. All honour and glory are yours, O loving Father, for ever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Every time we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Jesus, Lamb of God,
have mercy
on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. Jesus, Redeemer of the world, grant us peace. So draw near with faith, as you are in your own homes. Oops, no, you're right, that's it. So as we eat and drink, may you also receive communion spiritually in your hearts. No, they want the words.
Thank you.
sweetheart. So let us pray first the prayer for today, then the one we say together. O God, whose beauty is beyond our imagining and whose power we cannot comprehend, show us your glory as far as we can grasp it, and shield us from knowing more than we can bear, until we may look upon you without fear, through Jesus Christ our Saviour. Amen.
Amen.
We say together, Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. And may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you always. Amen.
Amen.
So let's have our notices. Bible study on Thursday by Zoom. If you want to join in, please give me your email. Gary, you will get an invitation.
Yeah.
And so if anyone else wants to join in on Zoom, send me your email address and I will send you the link. We've done birthdays and anniversaries. Pray for the youth group. Let's pray for the youth as they go out. Father God, we go out, they'll stay in, but you know what I mean. Father God, we pray for our youth group and for the leaders that as they meet by Zoom, that you'll bless their meeting together. We ask this for the meeting today and for that one on Wednesday. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
All-age worship didn't happen today because I was caught up with the technicalities of today's sermon. As you could see, that PowerPoint took longer than I anticipated. But even before I got to preparing that, I felt no inclination to do the All Age this week. I don't really know why. It's one of those things. It's a great wisdom in the church of knowing when something's had its day and it's time to stop it, perhaps. But this week I will be having a meeting with the Standing Committee of St Michael's and also the ministry team over the whole benefice. So that's two separate meetings. Oh joy, back to meetings. Either Zoom or I'm not sure if we're allowed to meet in person. I'm not up to speed on social gatherings and bubbles and all this stuff. So it probably will be by Zoom. I need to also talk to All Saints people because they would like their church opening up next week for worship as well. But as of yesterday, when I looked at the Church of England website, it just said that they were awaiting government guidance. So that's why we don't know what we're doing, because the government haven't told us what we're doing yet. Very frustrating, but at least they're hopefully thinking about it. I hope they're thinking about it and that's the delay. But there you go. We wait and see. And I think that's it for notices. What we got next? We've got our final hymn next, which I've forgotten what it is, so you'll have to wait and see. What is it? To God be the glory. To God be the glory, great things he hath done. So loved he the world that he gave us his Son, who yielded his life on atonement for sin, and opened the life gate that all may go in. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, let the earth hear his voice. Praise the Lord, So go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen. So goodbye and see you all at some point, somewhere. We wait and see. There will be night prayer tonight, probably about 6:30-ish, maybe. We'll see. Depends when I've negotiated with the chef about the time of our evening meal. So bye-bye then. God bless. And Terry, do you want to say goodbye to the people? They've not seen you because you've not done the reading. Come and say goodbye.
It's been behind the scenes. Bye. It's been nice reading all the messages and really looking forward to seeing you all in the flesh again soon. It's still been good to be together, though.
Yeah, okay. So bye-bye. You'll now go and press the button.